So the Ohio State University is having the players sign a waiver, basically saying, hey, we acknowledge that COVID-19 is a thing and the school can't protect us. Now, I want to get into the language here obtained by the Columbus Dispatch in this two-page document, which is referred to as the Buckeye Pledge. It asks players to, quote, pledge to take responsibility for my own health and help stop the spread of the COVID-19. Now, what's interesting about that is pledges of this kind are not really that abnormal. As a matter of fact, I mean, I can remember signing these in high school for high school football and attending summer pride, basically saying, hey, I'm going to do my best all the time. I'm going to show up when I'm supposed to show up. I'm going to finish workouts. I'm going to finish sets. I'm going to finish strong. And, you know, we had something similar in Boy Scouts. We still have something similar in Boy Scouts. I'm an Eagle Scout. I take it very seriously. But, I mean, it's on my honor. I will do my best to do my duty to God and my country, to obey the Scout law, to help other people at all times, to keep myself physically strong, mentally fit, morally straight. I mean, yeah, that's the pledge. That's what you hold dear. But it's not a binding legal document, right? And I don't think that this is either. And Gene Smith, for his part, athletic director at Ohio State, said as much to ESPN, saying, quote, we don't look at this as a legal document. It's a Buckeye pledge. Allow us to help you so that if we face the situation, our trainers, our strength coaches, our coaches, or any athletic administrator sees a student athlete not wearing a mask or not socially distancing, we can say, hey, you made a commitment, you signed a pledge, your parents signed a pledge, your parents are a part of this. Now, what I found interesting about that is that if it's not a legal document, how come parents of minors have to sign it? Because that's part of this deal, right? And that's the part that tipped me off, right? And it's a way of trying to get out of liability and allow for a disclaimer. Now, talking to attorneys, because I'm not a legal scholar, it won't really hold up. A judge will probably laugh at it if you want to go to court in some sort of class action way. However, I mean, it's Buckeye football. The chances of that, I think, are minimal because most of the kids want to play. And that's the part that needs to be underscored here. The kids want to play. The kids want to be safe, but the kids want to be safe socially. They don't want to be lambasted. They don't want to be made fun of. They don't want to look bad. Same thing with their parents. They want them to play. And while I am conflicted about this and I will remain conflicted about this, I can acknowledge wanting to play. I can also acknowledge the psychological warfare that goes on in a college football setting. I can acknowledge that there are little things that become big things that you don't look for a coach to stop yelling at you. You look for a coach who ignores you, because when they ignore you, then you should worry. And if you're worrying for good reason, right? I see this more often than I see good stories play out. Players get moved around. Players get pushed to the back of drills. Players are made to understand that their place is not just changeable, but so is the attitude of their coaches, position coaches, coordinators, strength coaches, all of it. It all matters. It's why the Chris Doyle situation at Iowa is such a big deal. Because what we're really talking about is kids. Some of them are legal adults. Some of them are learning to become, all of them are learning to become adults. And yet these men, and they're nearly always men, are responsible for, one, teaching them discipline, but also caring for them. One of the things that I've always valued about good parents is the ability to create a landscape where the kid believes that they're on their own, not knowing that there are these invisible barriers, these invisible fences that are going to keep them from falling over or falling off. It's one of the very cool things about good parents. You don't know that there's a net there, so you operate as if there's not a net there. All the while, the parents are like, no, if you fall, I'm going to catch you, in the back of their heads. But they also are going to catch you in such a way that you feel that thud, and you don't like that thud, and you get back up. where this pledge fits in that continuum is going to be something that we're going to be watching closely to see how, because the kids have to sign this thing to go play. The kids have to sign this thing to go work out, right? The school asked players to, quote, participate fully and honestly, unquote, with its athletic training staff and contact tracing. I don't see this as a particular win for anybody. And I wonder whether or not more schools are going to engage in trying to have their kids sign these pledges. Because in the way that you're asking the kids to pledge to you, right? Has Ryan Day signed a pledge to each one of his kids? Some of you might call that a national letter of intent. Other of you would say, no, he hasn't. But he doesn't have to, right? The kids are the labor here. He is going to make millions of dollars one way or the other. That's the other part about this that I find to be really fascinating. Let's say we get to the point where there is no college football season. Coaches aren't going to give the money back. They're going to take the money. They're getting paid one way or the other. They're getting paid in severance every time they get fired. As a matter of fact, David Beatty sued and won. Brett Bielema filed suit against the Razorback Foundation. He's probably going to get his money. I need to dig into this a little bit more because I think it's interesting. But the coaches get paid. If the players don't play and they don't get to go to class in the way that we're all expecting to go to class, what are they actually getting? The shaft. And I want to prevent that from happening. I want it to mean something different.